Thank you. studies have got it live, third place in social studies, achievement in social studies this year.
This is going to be just a little bit unhandy getting in and out, so we're slow. It's a little bit unhandy, but we're sort of cramped the roof. It's hard to get in and out.
Second place in social studies, 94.5 average, Richard Wells. Second place in the past average for Tracy Aldridge. Joshua. too, which is Crystal Bannon had the best average.
Expected that. I think we surprised with that last year.
It's a Ephesians in chapter 2, in verse 10, the scripture says, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them." Now, the scripture says that a Christian should walk in good works. That should be how we recognize Christians. That's how we should know a Christian, by his good works. But God's plan is a tailor-made plan. It's a specific plan. The Apostle Paul said, "I have finished my personal. I have finished my course." I hope when Joey gets down to the end of life, I hope that he can say that I have finished my course. I have finished my course. It's a personal plan. And the scripture says that I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way that thou shalt go. I'll say it's good tonight to know that we can depend upon the Lord. I will tell Joey tonight that he can trust the Lord in every circumstance and every situation that life will give him. And I will say that God will afford him every opportunity if Joey will be faithful to him, to the Lord, and do what the Lord would have him to do. God has a plan for our life, and he has a personal plan for us. God expects us to inquire about that plan. All of us that are Christians understand the importance of prayer life. And I want to say, in finding the will of God, in finding that plan, that you cannot find the will of God outside of prayer life. Joey will have to find a time when he can pray and submit his life to the will of the Lord. The Lord can reveal his will to him. I'll say this, a lot of people have made the will of God to be something spooky and something mysterious. I have not found that to be so in my life. I believe the will of God is revealed step by step, day by day. And as we serve the Lord, God reveals his perfect will for us. I will say also tonight that God's plan is important for every person. Now, I want to say that you can miss the will of God. Everyone here tonight is not in the perfect will of God tonight. Everyone here is not in the perfect will of God. The will of God is something that you can miss. So when you need to realize that you can miss the will of God. The scripture says that God is not willing that any should perish, that all should come to repentance. I want to say tonight, if you're here and you're lost, that what I mean by that term is, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, you do not know him as your Savior, he is not willing that any of you should perish. All of you should come to repentance. All of you can know the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Salvation is a simple matter, and it's a matter of choice. And God's not willing that any should perish, but all should come to repentance. But you can miss the will of God. I know the way. The scripture says, "I know the way of a man, and it is not in himself." We have many people today who believe that they can plan their own lives, they can do what they want to do in their own life, and yet please God. I want to tell you that's not so according to the Word of God. God's Word expects us to depend upon him and allow him to guide and direct in our life. The honest truth of it is no one here tonight, no matter how intelligent or how uneducated, no one here tonight has the ability or is capable of guiding or directing their own life. All of us are dependent upon God, whether we realize that or not tonight. So we need to realize tonight, no matter what vocation, I don't know what Joy's planning to do, no matter what vocation he plans on, that he'll need God to direct and choose and guide him in the choice of his vocation in life. I pray that God will truly use him and take the preparation that he's received in this school, and God will use him. I want to say also, it is always the will of God and always the plan of God that a Christian be godly. That a Christian be godly. The world tonight is lacking for Christianity will stand up for the Lord, will go out to the world and live for the Lord. I would say one of the easiest places to live for the Lord is inside the four walls of the church. It's a different story when you get outside the four walls and you have to live your Christianity that you say you believe and profess that you believe. And I would say that Joey is going to fight a battle, as each and every Christian that truly lives for the Lord and loves the Lord is going to do. So there is a matter of separation. What we mean by that is being separated from the world and so on. So he's not only going to live separated, but he is going to live a life of prayer and a life of good deeds. As we mentioned earlier, I believe his life should be marked by good deeds. And as his life is marked by good deeds, he'll have a good testimony for the Lord. He'll uplift the Lord Jesus Christ and the ministry of this church and of this staff and of this dear pastor. So it is God's plan that we have a godly life. A life that not only we talk about, but a life that we live. I want to say that your walk will far outlast your talk. Joey, your walk will far outlast your talk. People, you can profess to be whatever you might profess to be tonight, but your walk will far, far exceed your talk. The world is looking for people who will walk what they talk about. I want to give a few things here and read just a few passages of Scripture, or a couple verses of Scripture, excuse me, from Psalm 37. And David wrote in Psalm 37, the first few verses, "Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass, and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land. And verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth the wicked devices to pass." But I will say there's a formula there in the book of Psalms, 37th Psalm, verses 1 through 7, that will help us in our guidance in the will of God. The Scripture says there that we should trust in the Lord, trust in him, put our confidence in the Lord. I would say most of us have our confidence in the wrong thing. Most of us today have our confidence in a job. We have our confidence in a home. We have our confidence in a family. But we really don't have our trust and our confidence in the Lord. I hope Joy will learn to have his confidence and his trust in the Lord. I hope that he'll delight himself in the Lord. No matter what he does in this life, I hope he will delight himself in serving the Lord. Now, a lot of Christianity will say this, and you can look at a lot of Christians' faces tonight. You can never see that there's any real joy in serving the Lord. But I will say there is real joy in serving the Lord tonight. There's real happiness. There's real peace. There's real contentment knowing that you're doing the will of God. Joy will find that if he'll be faithful to the Lord and if he'll delight himself in the Lord. Then the Scripture says, "Commit thy way unto the Lord." Now, our ways are not God's ways. And God expects us to commit our ways unto him. That is, put our way before him and allow him to guide us and to direct us. And then it says, rest in the Lord. Rest in the Lord. And that's a picture of contentment. I would say the Christian tonight who is resting in the Lord is contented in the Lord tonight. I love you to be happy. They are happy. They're contented with what the Lord has done for them and in their life. I believe that joy, if he'll be faithful to the Lord, he'll be content with what the Lord is doing in his life. Now, there's many methods of guidance in finding the will of God. There's a lot said today about finding the will of God in that it's mysterious, as I mentioned earlier, or something foreign. But I want to say you'll not find the will of God, Joey, outside of the Word of God. That's why we still have this book. This book is the very Word of God. Infallible, inerrant, the very Word of God. Every page of it is true. Every page of it will come to pass. Not one word, not one tittle will be removed. Everything is true in this book, in this Word of God. So God will bring it all to pass. Doesn't make any difference. Someone says, "Well, I don't believe that tonight." Doesn't make any difference at all. It'll come to pass anyway. You'll just stand in view, and you'll understand that it's all true when it's all said and done. The Word of God is true, and he'll not know the Word of God, nor will anyone here know the Word, the will of God outside the Word of God. Now, great benefit of being saved is not only having the Word of God, but having the Spirit of God to direct our life. And those two are in agreement. Those two never disagree. The Word of God and the Spirit of God never disagree. There's no disagreement there. And so they are always true, and we can depend upon the Word of God and His precious Spirit that lives within the believer. And then circumstances, and under this methods of finding guidance on the will of God. God will give circumstances to Jonah in his life. What I mean by that, he'll open and close doors to reveal what the will of God is for him. Again, let me say, it's not mysterious, it's not foreign, it's not something that cannot be known. And I believe that you can know the perfect will of God, and I believe that God wants us to know the will of God. So nothing happens to the child of God what I'm trying to say is there is no accidents take place with the child of God. So anything that happens in Joy's life will be for a reason, will be for a purpose. I will say that everything happens in my life and in your life tonight, if you're saved, has a purpose behind it. Right. And so there's no accidents with God. God doesn't have any accidents. Now, in conclusion tonight, I want to say this, Joy, you need to determine in your life to do the will of God. It's going to take some determination. It's not always going to be easy. I've served the Lord long enough now. I've preached the gospel long enough now. It seems at times the further you go, the more difficult it becomes. It's going to take some real determination. I've said this to my church, and I'll say it again. It takes a real man to serve God. It takes a real woman with character to serve God. It takes some real young people with some character to serve God. I'll say this. Sometimes even in a Christian school, a fellow who really wants to serve God is somewhat of a misfit. I say, oh, you don't know what you're talking about. Oh, yes, I know what I'm talking about. I have one. I've seen it. So sometimes you are a misfit. You really want to determine to serve God. That's all right. That's the price that has to be paid to serve God. So I pray that, Joy, tonight that you'll determine to serve God. George Mueller, the great saint of the past, said this in regard to the will of God. He said, surrender your will. Seek God's leadership through the Spirit and His Word. Pray for guidance and wait upon God. That was his formula. God only knows how much George Mueller in his lifetime prayed in by faith, waiting upon God, a man that knew God, a man that walked with God in a personal way. I want to say that we need more Christians like George Mueller. This day and age, we need a multitude of Christians like George Mueller. America tonight is in desperate need of strong, outstanding Christians. I pray that Joy will be that type of a Christian. William Carey said this, a great missionary in the past. He said, attempt great things for God and expect great things from God. See, two things. We need to attempt it for God and then expect great things from God. God will always fulfill His part. Joy, you'll never be disappointed in serving God. Many times God is disappointed with us. Well, I've never been disappointed with the Lord. The Lord has never failed me. He's been faithful to me. Amen. All the way down to the time that I've been saved. I want to say this in closing. God will not measure Joy by the will of God for another man or another person. God will measure Joy by the will of God for Joy's life. I want to say, whatever the will of God is, Joy, you need to find it, stay in it, do it, be faithful, trust in Him. Let's bow our heads tonight and pray. Now, Father, tonight we pray that you'll take these words, help us more to learn from them, and not only learn from them, but truly experience them in our lives. And God, we're just grateful tonight that we can be here and share these thoughts from our heart. And God, I pray tonight for Joy in a special way. I congratulate him, Lord, for finishing the course here. Lord, I pray that as you reveal the word of God to him, through your Spirit and the will of God to him, Lord, that you'll direct his life, give him guidance and direction. And I pray, Father, that you'll use him now that he's completed his course for your honor and your glory. And we ask these things in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
I thought this was can't find staff anywhere that can show you any more love and kindness than what I've been shown here in these last few years. See, I was one of the first ones to attend the school when it started in 1982. It sort of makes me kind of nervous to know that I'm a first graduate and what I do with my life will replace Calvary Baptist School. I really need to pray as I take this step forward. None can come to appreciate Christian school more than I. See, I came out from a worldly school to a Christian school, and it was really a big change. See, there are teachers there that will curse you and then report you in for doing the same. There are teachers there that sell dope, and students that will take your money and beat you up if you didn't get it for them. Yes, coming out of a Christian school, coming out of a worldly school into a Christian school was different as night and day. Parents, friends, and even fellow students, we do not provide appreciate our teachers here, but I would like to take a moment to thank each and every one of our staff members here for putting up with me in these last few years. See, teachers in a public school, they strike you more money. But our teachers, they don't even receive a paycheck. Well, Parker, I want to thank you for coming to my house 5 years ago and allowing me to come to the school. You and Miss Parker gave over time more than any of us could have started. You see, I was born up here when you two had to break us into the red folks, colored folks. At times, I didn't understand what made you tick. I just thank God it's deep. Grandma's house and dragged me out with the other. I'd like to tell you about the teacher I met personally while I was here, the one that changed my life. See, he was the teacher that never taught a lesson in the classroom. He had no tools to work with, no blackboards, maps, and charts. He kept no records, gave no grades, and his only text was ancient and well-worn. The students were poor, the lame and the deaf, the blind, the outcast. His method was the same for all who came, from here to run. He opened his eyes, for faith, opened ears for simple truth, and open heart for love. A love born of forgiveness. A gentleman, a humble man. He asked for no honors, no gold awards, or tribute to his expertise or wisdom. Yet his white teeth from the hill of Galilee has met the needs, filled the hopes, and changed the lives of many millions. What he taught brought heaven to earth and God's heart to God. Yes, God sends the Savior. No, if our greatest need had been information, he would send us an educator. If our greatest need had been money, he would send us an economist. If our greatest need had been pleasure, he would send us an entertainer. But our greatest need was forgiveness, so he sent us a Savior.
Amen.
And I'd like to let you know our parents know that Savior on December the 3rd, 1986. And if there's anyone here tonight that does not come to know the Savior I'm talking about, I would like to encourage you to do so.